Bitcoin is all of the rage. In fact, these cryptocurrencies are something a lot of people have considered investing in. Of course, many have invested in it. I played around with them about a decade ago, and the IRS seized $1.2 billion worth of it. You might remember we talked years ago about the IRS trying to tax things in the virtual world. So if you were in one of these real life type things and you owned property, as it were, inside this virtual world, they wanted to tax it. Of course, if you sold something with real hard money and you sold it inside that real world with real hard money, you would end up having to pay taxes. Just if you sold a hammer to someone, that's the way it works. A lot of people have decided that for some reason, cryptocurrency is completely untrackable. Now, we know about cases, I've talked about them here, where some of these coins, and in this particular case, we're talking about Bitcoin, has been used online, and in fact, the government has found out who was using it and really stepped in a big way. Silk Road is the biggest example of that. This was an online black market for everything you can think of, from illegal drugs to firearms to all kinds of illegal commodities that were for sale online. This was back in 2013. They were using Bitcoin to buy and sell things on this free trade zone, I think they called themselves. And Silk Road was just thriving. On comes the federal government, and federal agents in the United States really cut their teeth in crypto search and seizure with taking down a Silk Road. You might remember, this was very unprecedented. People had no idea what they could do. How could the federal government monitor this? Can I buy and sell these bitcoins? All of that sort of thing. And 20 years as the chief of money laundering and asset forfeiture in U.S. Attorney's Office for the Southern District of New York, Sharon Levin, said that this whole takedown of Silk Road was completely unprecedented. And it was. It's new technology. What do you do? Well, because people hear cryptocurrency, and crypto, of course, being short for cryptography, they figure that, okay, well, obviously it is absolutely untraceable, untrackable. Tell that to the people that this year have tried to ransom money out of a number of U.S. corporations, some of them major. Consider, for instance, Colonial Pipeline and what happened with them and how at least half of their cryptocurrency was returned to them. So don't think that this stuff is a way that you can get away with breaking the law or not paying taxes. It is not. The whole business, if you will, of crypto seizure and sale is growing incredibly fast. In fact, the federal government just enlisted the help of the private sector to manage and store these crypto tokens that have been seized from people. Now, I mentioned that the IRS has seized about $1.2 billion worth of cryptocurrency this fiscal year. That is a whole lot of cryptocurrency. And what are they doing with it? Well, it's the same thing. Remember the drug dealers back in the 80s? Miami, what was happening? I used to love Miami Vice TV show. What happened there? Well, they seized boats, they seized cars, they seized cash. Obviously, they can just put back into circulation. But everything else, what do they do? Of course, they go ahead and they sell it at auction. And that's what they've been doing. In June, they started auctioning off Litecoin and Bitcoin Cash. They had 11 different lots on offer. It was a four-day auction, and it included 150.22567153 Litecoin. You like that? Remember, cryptocurrency is not necessarily a whole coin. It's like having a gold coin that's worth $500. How are you going to use that to buy a loaf? But what happens with these cryptocurrencies is you can buy and sell fractions of a coin. So that's why you get into the millionths of a piece of a coin. So they sold 150-ish Litecoin and about 0.00022 Bitcoin Cash worth more than 21 grand. So that's one of the 11 lots that was out there. And this crypto property is what they're calling it, had been confiscated as part of a tax non-compliance case. I'm looking right now at the public auction sale note and where it was, where you could go online. It was at gsaauctions.gov, if you want to check these things out, as in the General Services Administration, auctions.gov, gsaauctions.gov. And they were selling it, and it was a taxpayer. It tells you all kinds of information about them. It's kind of crazy here. But you have to pay by cash, a certified cashier's or treasurer's check drawn on different whatever banks, etc. It's really cool to look at some of these things. But you can find them online if you're interested in buying them. It might be a good way to buy them, to buy these various cryptocurrencies if you want to get into there. But a lot can refer to almost anything. Could be, as I said, boats or cars, like it was on Miami Vice. It could be some number of crypto coins that are being auctioned as well. So they're going to be doing more and more of that. Apparently, the feds are saying that they have no plans to step back from being basically a crypto broker. Here is the bottom line here, because they're seizing and selling all of these assets. So keep an eye out for that. Remember what is going on. The Silk Road site that I mentioned had been shut down, operating on the dark web. It used Bitcoin exclusively. Nowadays, they're using various other types of coinage. Most of them are ultimately traceable, and we're not going to get into all of the details behind it. But the bottom line is, so what do they do? Now, think about this. Silk Road had 30,000 Bitcoin that they were able to identify and seize. And it was probably the biggest Bitcoin seizure ever, and it sold for about $19 million. So that was quite a few years ago. So let me just pull up a calculator here. Say 30,000 times, what's Bitcoin nowadays? I'm not quite sure. Let's say it's $15,000. So in today's money, it had $500 million, today's value, $500 million worth of Bitcoin in there. Isn't that something? And that was all seized and it was all auctioned off. So keep an eye on that. They're following the money is the technique they're using. You can find out a lot more at usmarshals.gov. And that is how they found it. If you've got Bitcoin, you're going to have to sell it. You're going to have to transfer it. You have to do something with it. And that's where they're getting you, bottom line, particularly if you take the Bitcoin and turn it into something else. But this would take a while to explain. And I was very happy to be able to sit in on a presentation that was done by the Treasury Department on how they handle all of this. It's frankly very fascinating. Hey, make sure you spend a couple of minutes and join me online, craigpeterson.com. You can sign up for my newsletter, you can listen to my podcasts, and you can get some free special reports just for signing up.